Hey J Crew, happy new year. It's your girl Sherry J and I am back. It is 2017 and I am here with another mukbang. This mukbang is actually for one of my subscribers, Justin Baldwin, and he actually suggested that I do a Mexican mukbang. So that is what you have today for my first video of the new year. But before we get started, I do have one correction from my spaghetti mukbang that I did. The person that I shouted out as the requester was not the right name. Carson Park is actually the person that requested the spaghetti mukbang, and I promised him that I would make that correction, even though he was super cool about it and he didn't care. But I want to make sure that everybody gets shouted out that is part of the J Crew. So Carson Park, thank you again for the spaghetti mukbang request. That turned out really well. It was really good, so I did want to make that correction. But we are back, J Crew. It is 2017 and we have new videos coming. So keep the requests coming. I will get to them. May take me a while sometimes, but I will get to it. So Justin, this is for you. I am doing Mexican food today, and I'm gonna get right into showing you what I have. I have mole today. So this is gonna be my Mexican mukbang. And I have two tacos from Moe's that I'm going to have. Let me slide the camera back just a little bit so you can see them. So two tacos. And of course they give you chips. And I do like Moe's salsa, but I have fallen in love with the Tostitos Cantina style salsa. And this is the roasted garlic thick and chunky salsa by Tostitos. So this is what I'm going to have with my chips from Moe's. And to drink today, I have a Seagram's Raspberry Ginger Ale. And this actually came from the Coke machines that restaurants have now where you can mix the flavors and all of that. So this is the Seagram's Raspberry Ginger Ale that I'm drinking. So I want to go ahead and get that part out of the way before we get to talking and catching up, because it is a new year and there are, several things that we'll probably have to talk about. So let me get me some salsa out for my chips, and I just have a little bowl that I'm going to put it in. So I'm going to get me some of this out, just mix it up a little bit, make sure I get a little bit of everything. I'm just going to do a few spoons of this because I don't really eat that many chips when I eat my tacos, but I want to have a few. So, how have you guys been? How has everything been going in the new year for you all? Hopefully, great. I did take some vacation time over the Christmas holidays, and that was really nice. Got a lot of rest, got some things done around the house, things that you don't normally get to do, so that was good. But we are going to get right on into the eating. I'm going to start with some salsa and chips, so let's get started, J. Crew. Here's the first bite. Really, really good. This is the best salsa. Tostitos salsa, even the regular ones are good, but the Cantina style is really, really good. It's like, I guess, their restaurant style. And on my taco, everybody knows that Moe's puts their tacos in the little foil. I'm going to show you what I have on it. Well, I'm going to tell you and try to show you. So this is my steak taco. And on it I have steak, cheese, sour cream, guacamole, fresh cilantro, and pico de gallo. And I can't really show you, but it looks really good and it's just so fresh. So if you could see that. Everything is fresh on here. It's really good. So I'm gonna give it a bite. And of course, I have my napkins on standby. But Moe's has
really good tacos. And everything is fresh. And as you can see, I did do the soft taco. I don't really like crunchy tacos. I like the soft ones. So, it's what I have. It's really good. Oh, look at my cute little shirt I have on. It says, I don't want to. It's like one of my quotes that I love to say. And I actually found a shirt that has it on there. Got this at Five Below. So it's really cute. Of course, today is Martin Luther King Day. So everybody got a day off work to enjoy. To participate in some of the King activities, if that's your thing. So we always enjoy off days. That's good. And these are my chips. So if you see me reaching down, I'm getting chips for my salsa. Uh-oh, I left one in there. So, down in the comment section, tell me what you guys did for the new year. How your holidays were. If you got any cool gifts for Christmas. Let's talk. And I'm actually pretty hungry today, so I probably will be able to finish this. The cilantro is so good. It gives the taco such a good flavor. So if you never thought about putting fresh cilantro on your taco, do it. It's good. Let's try the ginger ale. Raspberry ginger ale is really good. This one I said before is by Seagram's. But I had another flavored ginger ale over the holidays. And it was by, I guess it's Swelps is the brand. And that's how it's pronounced. Really, really good. So flavored ginger ale is really good. But I love ginger ale, whether it's just the plain ones or whatever. But I've gotten into getting the flavored ones. And they taste really good also. And they're caffeine free. So if you're not really doing caffeine or you don't like caffeinated drinks, then ginger ale is a good alternative to having something with the fizz but not the caffeine. Break my chips because I don't like to eat a whole lot of them, so if I break them down in bite-sized pieces I can have less chips. Most people go to Moe's on Mondays for Moe's Monday. And it's a $5 any burrito on Mondays. But I like the tacos. They're just so good. And they're not as big. I'm trying to see if I have a story for you all. Let's see. What's happened? My holidays were good. Of course, I spent a lot of time with my family. We all got together and exchanged presents and enjoyed each other's company. Excuse me. And, all that good stuff. We played games. Listened to the Christmas music. Reminisced about old times. Caught up on current events. That's all that stuff. Because me and my family, we're just all over the place. We talk about whatever. But we have fun and we eat. If you've been watching my videos, you know that I'm a huge Alabama Crimson Tide fan. And, of course, we did not win the national championship game this year. But it was a really great game, so we're not sore losers. We still congratulate the Clemson Tigers on their win. Came down to the last second. So it was a good game. But we did not take home the title this year. A lot of people were happy about that. Look at that shot of the taco. Tacos can be kind of messy, but they are so good. Because everything wants to come out of the other end. Trying to push it back in there. And you can see all the ingredients. The cilantro, the pico, and the cheese, and the steak. Oh, last week we got a little bit of snow here in Alabama. Everybody was snowed in. And I'm laughing because even though it was like probably 2 inches of snow, we were snowed in. Everybody was off work. The kids were out of school. And we were all home. And now for the past week, it's been like 60, 70 degrees here. So winter in the South is so unpredictable. But it's fun because we get a little bit of cold and then we get some warm weather. It kind of goes back and forth. We're not freezing the whole winter, which is good. This is a big bite, but I'm gonna try to put all this in one bite. Because I want to actually finish this food today. Okay, so one taco gone. This is my other taco. Good. And let me tell you. I actually have a story about me getting this food. And it was Joseph and I. Joseph is my husband. We went out today and we did grocery shopping and all that stuff. And told him I had to make a video. So we went to get the food before we came home. And generally, Moe's has great service. But today was terrible. When we walked in the door, we didn't get a welcome to Moe's. We didn't get any of that. The people were just kind of standing around. One girl was doing something. She was actually working. The other people were just kind of standing around. Nobody greeted us or anything. She looked up from what she was doing and said, you know, hi, I'll be right with you. So she was trying. But mind you, she's the only person that was working. So we should have been greeted regardless. She came and helped us. And the person whom I assume was the manager was standing around just having a conversation. Not helping, not saying anything. So the girl made my taco. Look at that little piece of cilantro. So the girl made my taco and, well, my tacos. And I went to pay for the food. And the manager was standing there at the register talking to another one of the guys that worked there. And I stood there for a second before she even attempted to ring up the order. So finally she did that. She took my money, gave me my receipt and my cup to get my drink. And she never handed me the food. So Joseph was standing there and I just kind of looked at him like, is she serious? So I said, Joseph, get my food. Like he literally had to reach over the counter and get my food. And then I just went ahead and went to the drink station and got my drink. So, the service was terrible, but the food is really good. And the worst part about it is that the manager is the one who gave the bad service. It wasn't the other employee who was actually making the food. It's the person that was supposed to be in charge. And I'm like, really? You know, you're not greeting the customers. You're not, you know, saying, hey, thank you for coming. Have a great day. Nothing. She just took my money, gave me my change, and that was it. So, unfortunately, I did not have a good experience getting the food, but the food tastes good. So, I guess that's my consolation. Oh, look, there's a lot of guacamole on that side. It's going to be a good bite. Mmm. It is good. This mukbang was inspired by Chunky. You all will hear me mention her in a couple of my videos or have heard me mention her in a couple of my videos before. And she lives in LA. And so there are a lot of, you know, Mexican restaurants, Mexican people. And she did mukbang with tacos. And hers looks so good. She actually had carnitas. And I think carnitas have pork on them. So she had that. But she had like fresh avocado slices, cilantro, and all that other stuff on there. And they just look so good. So, of course, Moe's did not have fresh avocado, but they had the guacamole, so I did that. Just kind of substituted, but her tacos look so good, so that's who made me want to do a taco for my Mexican mukbang. Again, this mukbang is for Justin Baldwin. He suggested Mexican food, but the taco that I made is inspired by Chunky and the tacos that she was eating. And I also saw that Moe's now sells carnitas, so they do have the pork as well, but this is steak. Look, my cup says, "Welcome to Moe's." So maybe that was my greeting, huh? Welcome to Moe's.